grab his cigarette. He got it.
Oh my
picked it up.
God, that is
and
so
he's smoking it.
Gross.
And what kind of... That's nothing you can do about it.
There's nothing you can do about it. So, what's today? Today's Monday, June 29th. And by the time we're done with our morning spiel, we'll still be in this damn parking garage because I parked on the 9th floor. Anyway, we're headed to Starbucks for some quick breakfast so that we can hit the road. Today's surprise, boys and girls, is we're going to head out to Willow Beach. That's about an hour and 2 minutes, according to Google's, from downtown Vegas to Willow Beach, and it's as if you're headed towards
the Hoover Dam.
Hoover Dam. Now, you must excuse my appearance. I've got some zits going on, thanks to some masks we had to freaking wear all the time.
But I don't.
Perfect. He doesn't poop either. He doesn't fart. Just poop. His shit don't stink. He's not a goocher. What else? Well, how else are you?
I don't know. Perfect? Mr. Lucky.
Uh-huh. He's Mr. Lucky.
Hampay hog, that's what they call me.
Where's the Hampay? Huh?
It's waiting for me.
Oh,
there,
it's waiting for you.
You didn't let me play.
It's going to be waiting for
I would have been playing right now.
Time. Uh-huh.
I was going to get it today.
Today? We were supposed to leave yesterday, so I don't know what you're talking
plans.
About.
I had plans. I already knew we were staying.
Did you?
Yeah.
How come you didn't tell me when I made reservations?
Because it's too much overload for you. You can't deal with it.
This is too much overload. This.
You just can't. Do you need the card to get out?
I'm barely on room four. I got it. All right. Got an easy access. So.
Where the hell?
We're still on.
God damn it, I swear we're not re-looping this video.
We're on floor four. We were on nine. But like each floor is like two levels or something. Okay, we're on three now. So Willow Beach.
We're gonna canoe.
Willow Beach Marina. It's based right there on the Colorado River, just south of the Hoover Dam. We rented a canoe, so I prepaid for it. It came out to like $111 for the whole day. A whole day right now is from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. But I think the canoe rental needs to be put back. Because whatever you rented needs to be brought back by like 2 or something.
We're going to have a canole and a canoe.
A canole and a canoe. And... there's like two stops that we want to canoe to. One's like an old schoolhouse that was there like in the 1910s, 1920s. Oh, was that thing up this whole
time? Yeah, it was already up.
Oh, why didn't you tell me?
I don't know.
All right, the other thing is Emerald Cove. It's like a cave, water looks all emeraldy.
Emeraldy.
Whoa, I don't have my blinker on, buddy.
Let's see if it really does look that green like they show in pictures.
Yeah, I'll have to let you know. But say lovey.
What is that?
It's trash. Leaves.
Just leaves. From the windstorm.
Yeah.
Alright, we had fun.
We had fun.
But my voice is blown out, you know. We had fun.
We'll do that wrap up, I guess, tonight.
Oh, it's not over, guys.
It's not over. This is the nature side of Vegas, guys. So this Willow Beach Marina place, they can even pick you up at your hotel, I think. Or there's a, not at your hotel, there's a spot in town that you would Uber to or drive to, and they shuttle you out. So it would be a day trip. So if you need a break from cigarette smoke, from noise, you're here long enough, or if you have kids, look at this douchebag.
Ooh, douchebag. Mm-hmm. We got a real douchebag here.
Get out of here.
Just kidding, if that's your... Uh-oh.
Oh.
What happened?
That's okay.
She's running in stilettos to go bail her boyfriend out of jail.
Oh my god, I can't believe he got a...
Oh my god.
I can't believe he got a DUI.
I don't know where I'm at. Oh, okay, now I know. All right, this was the longest morning intro ever, but that's the next hour will be on the road, so you won't even hear from us until we get to Willow Beach.
That's a, what do you call it? Courthouse.
Gelato, the best pizza in Vegas. Breakfast served all day.
I'm
going to
get a gelato.
What's this place
called? I'm going to get a gelato. I'm going to get a gelato. What do you want? You want a gelato or you want a canoe?
Oh, God. All right, guys, we'll see you at the beach.
The beach. Beaches.
Ooh, and it's a perfect day because it's the 80s.
It's not over yet.
So it's not, and there's a nice cool breeze. Oh, I'm loving it right now. Let's hope it's nice on the water.
Smoke on the water.
Sand people up in here. Is that what they were called?
Yeah.
Sand people.
That's not like a derogatory term for something.
Not like that.
Star Wars. Star Wars.
Those people that are shooting.
Yeah. Oh, we're off the road.
I think we're here.
We made it. Mm-hmm. Oh. There's what stuff over there. All the canoes.
All the canoes. I guess you can bring your own stuff and unload there.
Yeah.
Damn, did we get here too late? Oh, shit.
We got here late.
I wanted to get here at 8. It's 10:21. No, it's 10:15. We have restrooms over here.
That whole lake is a restroom.
That's gross. Look, people brought their lunch. What are we going to
do? Nothing.
I have Pringles.
We got Horny Mike's nuts. And his meat.
Jesus.
We're here.
All right, people.
World's largest ball of twine.
We'll see you in a bit.
See you in a bit.
We probably should have, while we were at the gas station, bought waters and stuff to put them in here. Let's see if they have water for sale.
Store. Order the canoe, and we're gonna pick up some water right here. Probably.
Drinks?
Yeah.
Kind of wish you waited for me.
Why?
Because maybe I wanted to get something.
We got water.
Hi.
Hi. How do you do?
Hi. Good.
You guys get married? Alright, I got you right over here. You guys paddled out here before?
No.
Oh, this is our first time.
Nice and welcome. Right inside that door that's open, first door on your right. Go ahead and pick yourself out a couple of life jackets.
Okay.
I guess. How are you feeling, Toussaint?
I hate having to wear used life vests, especially in these times. You know what I mean?
Yep. What would 2 pence say for Nicky Famish's father?
What would 2 pence say?
Yeah. The British version of you.
Just I don't know. I can't wait to get out on the water.
There you go.
I look forward to it. Ah, that end kind of sounded Australian.
I don't see a motor on this thing. Where the hell's the engine?
It's right here.
Ah, crap.
Right here. So what do you want, front or back?
Oh, I think you know.
I'll take the rear.
That means
I ruin every video. I ruin every video with stupid humor.
That means I do more work.
No. I need to be in rear because I want you to steer.
You steer from the rear.
No.
Yeah.
You're guiding us. You're the Indian.
Alright.
Alright, you guys ready?
Yes.
Yeah.
You want to spray this out a little for you? Or do you
If it's no problem, I don't know.
It's up to you.
Yeah, please. Sorry.
We're going to work as a team here.
Well, you're not working.
Go ahead. I'm working. Look, I'm rowing.
Can you get out? Can you put that down and can we get out first?
She's already nervous. Here we are, boys. Uh-oh, we're drifting.
Well, because I'm taking my mask off, so chill.
We're drifting. This footage is no good now. We're not... What river is this?
Colorado.
Oh. We're in the Colorado River.
What river this is?
We're in the Colorado River. Who knows where we'll end up with 2 cents steering.
You're giving me your mask.
They are. Lake Havasu, 1999.
It's 1995, Scott D, Tammy C, spring break, Lake Havasu. We're out here in Copper Canyon. We're having a great time.
We're making good time, guys. I'm doing all the work here. Good job. This is easy.
So it takes an hour to get to Emerald Cove, but halfway there, we want to get to that that foundation of where that old house used to be. There's like some history markers there we can read.
All right.
So
let's go.
Let's
go. Let's do the ass. Toussaint Rose like she drives. All right, I'm not paddling. Just don't get us into that pump station over there. What does that say? Danger? Hoover Dam drop off?
I think we're almost there. We're hoping we're almost there. I want to eat some Pringles and drink some water. I'm hangry now.
There she is.
All right. I need to stretch my legs.
Good job. Put your rudder up as you come in.
All right, let's go.
Where's the slots? But we're gonna run out of battery.
Just get a little bit, like our entry.
Well, that's what I was doing.
No, you were standing in the water from the people.
No. I got us landing. We made it to the site.
All right, we're gonna walk up this trail.
Historical trail starts here, it
I
says.
Think we're going the right way.
I don't know where the hell we're going.
I just needed a break.
Watch out for the sand people. She's like.
I think we need to go up that way, right? See, there's a trail there?
Yep. We're going to the trail where it says historical trail. Oh no, guys, tourists. God.
Suck is if we started seeing our canoeing.
Hey, canoe isn't that a boat over there?
Wait a minute.
How the hell are we getting back? We're gonna have to Chevy Chase it through the mountains. It is so pretty though. It's amazing just.
Every time we're driving home on the freeway and I look down into the valley and I see the blue, crisp water.
Yeah.
I just long to be just, down here.
Yeah, just being in the dry desert. Yeah, this is a spot, man, to kick back. Oh my god. Don, you would love drinking beers right out here. All right, let's check out this little foundation. See their steps? Whoever had a house here, this was a prime spot. What does this say? River Gauger's house site.
Gouger.
River
Gouger's Gouger. House site.
1920
to 1935.
Snow-capped Rockies. So this water's from the snow in the Rockies.
Travels 1,400 miles through the Greenlands and arid deserts of seven states before reaching the Gulf of California. Man sought for decades to harness the power of this mighty river. Their dreams became a reality with the completion of Hoover Dam in 1935. In order to measure the impact of this massive engineering project, several measuring stations were built. You are standing at the house site of a river gouger who operated one such station. Constructed by United States Geological Survey, the stone foundations are all that remain of his one-bedroom house and garage. Each day, the gouger would walk along the stone-marked trail to the cable carts where he would pull himself out over the river to take measurements. These were then computed to establish the volume of water, the rate of flow, and the silt content. Tamed by a series of dams, the enormous energy of the Colorado River has been captured for use by man. The roaring rapids that existed when the River Gouger lived here now lie hidden beneath Lake Mojave.
Dude, this guy had the job. dream job. Yeah, I'm gonna go out and see how, yep, it's deep. Done. Come back home, have a barbecue, get some beers going down. That's right.
Is that like an old sink over there?
Yeah, looks like it. This guy had it made. This is a nice spot. So what happened, like why is there just nothing left? Yeah, probably. Yeah, it was a sink. I wonder why they didn't just like keep it up. I mean, like, obviously they didn't need him for the job anymore, but why not keep it as some kind of ranger shack or something? It's actually a nice day today, especially for Vegas. I think it was in the 80s today. So it could have been a lot hotter out here. And yesterday was a crazy windstorm, so this is really actually a good day. We picked a good day coming back. There she is. She's looking for a lightning link. Huh? I said you're looking for a lightning link. How beautiful. He's got a little shark fin. It's great. That's gorgeous. Ooh. Oh my god, that's a beautiful dog. Beautiful. Sent out of fuel. She's popping her Pringles.
I got hungry. Who's ever eaten Pringles on the Colorado River?
I don't know.
Barbecue ones. Oh, I should probably pass them.
She's just worried about COVID out here. Salmonella. Oh crap, he knows he's coming for your Pringles.
He's coming for my Pringles.
This is a nice little shady spot from the sun. The non-tourist side. It looks like they're on a tour, like actually on a tour. Those people. They had like a tour guide.
That lady was giving history lessons.
Yeah. Plant information and stuff like that. Running out of battery. Hopefully. That's a cool little spot, little cave over there. Come on, row! Put your back into it.
Put your back.
Very cool. Very pretty here. Yeah. Alright, going to Emerald Cove.
Cove. Emerald Cove?
Emerald Cove.
Ooh.
Do you see like
Yeah, the little nests.
Yeah.
Very pretty. So, if you do rent a car in Vegas, I would say it's worth it to come out here.
Look at the
entrance
like that.
Yep. Rent a paddleboard, canoe. Kayak, yeah, it's really actually nice, really nice out here, and the water is beautiful. And there's that emerald color.
All right, ready?
I'm ready.
Oh, I have a pretzel.
You want a pretzel?
Oh, he likes pretzels. Look at that.
He's like, what is this? Gluten-free?
It's gluten-free, guys. Gluten-free pretzel. All right, I made a duck happy today.
Yeah.
All right, we can go back now.
Okay. 2 cent drive-in. Look at it. She's running into things, even on a river. This doesn't look like Jerry's nugget. Took me to the wrong spot.
Whoops. Oh, that duck is horny.
Oh, crap, he's after us. Once more. Oh, God, there's tourists. Some sort of tour group.
All right, look, here, another one. Another pretzel? Quack,
quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack, quack. He's gonna hand fed. Oh, look, she's nervous. She's scared.
Well, I don't know.
He don't have teeth, so what do you think it's gonna do? Oh, coming in hot.
Oh my God, did it fly in?
Yep. Coming in hot.
Alright.
Oh, he's like, get you. Check yourself. Okay.
You start a duck bike?
Yeah. Damn tourism. Ruins everything.
What are we?
We're locals.
No, we're not.
I missed it. She was.
But you're the brake.
She was just under that bush. That's where she steered us. Right into the.
Oh, us? Us? You're the brake back there. That's the second time you didn't use the brake.
She just steered us into this tree. She just did the limbo. Someone's going to comment about you destroying nature.
I'm not. They're eating it.
Look, we're running into a rock. She doesn't know because she's not paying attention.
Yeah,
we're slowly going into a rock. Just like her driving. Pennies, hey. It's the same on a river.
I've never.
She's exactly.
No, I've never crashed. So, mm-hmm. Whatever.
Only the people around her have crashed. Coming back home. We're gonna dock, get to the car, start the drive.
Scottsdale.
To Scottsdale. Spend the night in Scottsdale, and then
we're gonna have lunch in
Kingman. Oh, okay.
Starving.
Yep. All right, guys. It was fun. Definitely worth it.
Yep.
Come check it out. What'd you think?
It was so worth it. Yeah. I just wish we got here earlier, like at 8, like planned, but we got here like at 10:15, 10:30.
But it was beautiful.
It was, the water. But if we had gone here at 8, we would have made it back down with a nice cool breeze and stuff.
Yeah.
But now it's kicked back on now that we're here.
Yeah. But the water, oh my god, perfect temperature, real clear.
At first it's cold.
You can see the bottom in some areas.
Yeah. At first it's cold water, but
it feels great.
It was a good workout.
Yeah.
If you bring like a little mini ice chest, like this kind of a thing, put some ice packs, some cool drinks, some snacks, you're good to go.
Yeah, you can find a little picnic area.
And then if it's a day trip from Vegas, you just head back. Get freshened up and have a nice day.
Yeah, I would totally do that. So 2 Cent just went into this Circle K to get a Red Bull. Politics aside, I know she's freaking out because there's so many people not wearing masks or gloves, and whatever side you pick about that, you know, there's nothing wrong, whatever, you believe whatever you believe, but I know she's gonna be freaking out because there's people walking in and out with nothing on. And anyway, this guy smoking a cigarette came in and he just put his cigarette on that red pole so that he can finish smoking it when he comes out of the Circle K. I know he's gonna grab it when he comes back out those doors and pick his cigarette up. That would totally freak her out, man. So she is probably bugging out in there. She's got a glove on and her mask on, and nobody else has shit. Oh, there she goes. I can tell. There's her. I can tell that was a living hell for her right now. Like, total COVID central.
No one's fucking wearing masks up in there, dude.
I started rolling because I'm waiting for him to come back out, but this dude's smoking a cigarette. He put his cigarette right on that red pole. It was already lit and he's smoking it. He laid it on that pole so he can come back out and pick it up and start smoking it again.
On the COVID pole?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna go throw this glove out.
Alright.
And then the lady at the register, even though there's plexiglass, was wearing a chin strap.
Yeah. See, they're all looking at her like she's crazy. Everybody's looking at you like you're
the
crazy one.
Crazy one, dude.
Yeah.
No wonder the numbers are going up in Arizona, dude. That's scary shit, dude.
They don't give up.
I'm sorry for cussing people.
They don't give a crap.
Even with gloves, dude. Like, I just want to take a shower and hand sanitizer. So this kid, he opened up the door for me, right? I don't know if you saw him.
Yeah.
And he's like, and he wasn't wearing a mask. I'm like, no, I'm gonna have to be like within 4 feet of him, or at least 3. And I'm
He just spit. He just spit right in front of himself.
He spit because he doesn't have a mask on, right?
Yeah. See,
Single person that's walked in there does not have a mask on. There was this one dude that had a mask on in there that had walked in before me. Look, And even what I do, I have this can of Red Balls here.
There's another one, no mask. They don't believe in it, dude. I think it's the area.
Oh, here he's the smoker. There, he's gonna grab his cigarette. He got it.
Oh my
picked it up.
God, that is
and
so
he's smoking it.
Gross.
And what kind of, what virus?
Oh my god. Okay, so now.
He looks healthy.
Dude.
I'm just gonna continue to smoke.
All right. So see what I'm doing?
Uh-huh.
With my wet ones, I am cleaning it, which we probably should do anyway, because I know I've been guilty of it, grabbing the one right up front and then grabbing like two, like the can that's like two or three deep in, right?
Yep.
Right. So I had sanitized my hand and yeah. And even the bottom guys, because this, I sat it on top of the counter. And sometimes I have a tendency to grab my can under the, underneath. Yeah, so, I mean, this might be ridiculous, guys, but you saw. Someone opens up the case where all the drinks are, and then all of a sudden they can't help and they sneeze.
Yeah.
Ew. That's why I don't grab the ones in the front. All right, dudes.
All right.
Off to Scottsdale. We've done our rant for today.
That was great.